Brother, I do not like this. The problem is that I title all my videos, like, based on my rank. Maybe I'm gonna have to start titling them by the MMR of the game, because, like, this is not silver. Brother man. A coaching on how to consistently win games for you or what? What am I pathing to even this game? Bot lane? There's no way I'm pathing to this thing. What the fuck? This champ is Exodia. We're not pathing to that. Well, I don't really want to coach right now since I just started playing, but if you send a bot, then I can review it in queue or something. That applies to anyone, really. If you send stuff, I can review it in queue. Don't really mind. Van Divi dot? Yeah, why not? Just player champ. Though I think you're gonna have to like pick up a second champ if you wanna actually play the game while playing Evelynn. Because people love to ban it in the US. Dun, dun, da, 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 da. I need to stop spacing out. I'm disgustingly spacing out right now. Because I just woke up. I usually like spend like 2-3 hours doing whatever bullshit before I play. Okay, I guess. Now the issue is that because Silas hasn't ganked anything, there's like a 50% chance he's just invading me. And you can just spawn out of this bush, so I need to be ready to flash anytime. I should really buy potions in these matchups. That would be like way higher HP. Brother man, what are you doing? Friends, buddies, pals. Another wave is like bouncing and they come back and they can all in my bot lane again. Lovely. Let's check this. Literally nothing to do right now. But I should ping that guy, that guy's there. So that guy is either going to dive top lane or he's going to gank mid lane, but most likely he dives top lane. Not much of a real point to walk to the second scuttle since we're pretty sure it's gone. Technically, I could sit in the bush there and I could wait. I'd like to learn Shyvana in a moment. You played a fair bit of Diana, but it's like my pick combine. Ah, I see. Yep. Wait. He's not topside. Wait, what? What does he do? Wait, he's 20 CS. I mean, he has a smite, so he's probably gonna smite this thing, but if he, like, pulls it badly... I have time right now to check. Okay. He's dead. Not bad, like... the reason this can work for me is because I have extra time, right? Because I didn't waste any time, I didn't fuck around, I didn't, like, wait or something, right? And... the thing is... I know that if he gets close to me, like close to here, right? Like usually people don't really think about where they pull the camps, right? So if he pulls the camp in a bad spot, then I can either try to steal the camp or even try to kill him. Especially because I have items already. Like even if he was full HP and had every spell, I would beat him because I'm level 4 and he's level 3 and I have items and he doesn't. So yeah. A bit sad that he got the scuttle though. I think if I played it a bit better, I could get the scuttle as well. But the scuttle doesn't really matter too much. There are points in the game where taking the enemy's camps matters more, and there are points in the game where killing them matters more. And this is a point where killing them matters more. Mostly because I need gold, and also the camps don't give that much right now. Compared to like a bit later in the game. Yeah. Just full clear and then see what happens. Mess around, fuck around, you know? Fuck around, find out. It's like the graph, you know? Go. Okay, Tresh just left her solo. You always wanna like wait until you E or you can auto-attack for charm or something. No real reason to like let her have an outplay chance and try to just Q her. Because as you can see then, I need a damage. And trying to hit my Q for damage is like a pretty good idea. I avoided this so my Nami doesn't die because of her brain damage. And also so they can see, but like it's like 70% because I don't want my Nami to die because he has brain damage. There is Rihanna, yes. Hello. Good morning, Mitt. Good morning, Colin. Bam, bam. I mean, it's not morning for you, Colin. But, yeah. Okay, now I can gank top, mostly because I want Relentless stack. And it's like easiest to get it right now. It is? It's for him. Can I ask you if he slept well, at least? Did you sleep well, bro? Okay, so this guy, you just have to like stand in him so that his E breaks, but since he ignited me, I'm fucking off now. If he ignites you, you just stop trying to kill him. Because most of these champs do too much damage when they ignite you. So they actually stat check you, and they kill you before you do enough damage to kill them. Not a bad result though, at all. I do this so I know if he's doing scuttle or not. I have to be careful though, actually. Much better if I stand here, right now. Because Akshan disappeared from the map and he can go in this and just invade me. And try to kill me. So playing slow is much better. I will lose like a few seconds, but I won't die probably. If I'm full HP, I won't die to him regardless, but if I'm like 60%, I will get like 100 to 0. Okay, I mean, we did something in top, so let's just avoid top lane now. Easier to play in other lanes, since the champs are less broken in the other lanes. I mean, not really, but kinda. I don't know. Akshan's just something else. I don't think that champ is very normal. At least against me, that other champs are less broken at the moment. Technically, if I had a useful top laner, I can just walk into the auction, same as I did in top lane. Like, block his E and we just kill him, but I don't think my gangplank is that useful. Botlaners always hate clearing wards for some reason. Can just play like long combos. We kill. Take his camp. He might show up though while I'm taking the camp. But if he doesn't, then I for sure have to like go stealth after the camp. Okay, he's actually doing Herald. Okay, I guess. Forgot people can even do that. I haven't seen that in a while. Okay, take all of his camps then. Don't wanna dive bot since it's Zaya. Too annoying to dive. Actually, I will dive it. But I think I'll try to kill Tresh first. Since he's coming. Oh. Funny guy. Whatever. Let's fuck off then. Let's just ward here so we see that guy when he comes. Nothing to do, so I guess we do dragon. Oh, bot lane fighting, so let's go there. Yeah, dude, just look at the map when you do objectives and shit. Otherwise, it's pretty bad. This guy's like here. My bot lane is standing too far back, so they can't kill him. Lovely. Oh well. Let's do like one camp or something so we get mythic. I think we could have killed him, but whatever. Maybe we'll do more than one camp since I don't have ult, so if I'm already walking here, I might as well take more camps. I think I'll just take like three, I guess. Not gonna like make it really awkward for myself and try to clear everything. This is a waste of time. I don't have items, so I'm just baiting myself. Well, that's not how it works. I don't have ult. It would be very nice if I could ban like 5 champs in the game. I think I would ban Akshan, I would ban Qiyana, I would ban Katarina, I would ban Rengar and Jarvan. I think that's what I would ban. But most of those champs aren't worth banning when you only have one ban. Ah, that's good, they double kill. Good for them. I'll go invade then. I've been playing mostly through lane this game. I would ban Eve, Nida, Lee, Miva, and Draven. Okay, my bad. I mean, I still have Orianna and Kassadin then. What about that, huh? Huh? I think Zaya didn't ult from what I saw. You can't play either of those? I can. What do you mean? I was just 91 Wraith Master and Kat. I think she has ult, but yeah, that's fine. If I do it a bit faster, I'd probably kill her. What the fuck's my Nami doing? What is this NPC activity? I do want to take a dragon though, because if I don't take a dragon, this game is going to be awkward because my team is not doing well enough. And I'm also not getting to snowball as much as I need for it. So taking one dragon is very good. Should I play it next game? I'm not going to play it, bro. It's my Evelynn account. You're ill. Also, I don't like casting anymore because, I don't know, you don't play like full damage anymore. Boring. I mean, the most important thing at this point of the game is to not get like anxiety and feel like you will lose if you don't do some random shit. It's very easy to get like anxious and be like, yeah, I mean, anxiety, that's literally what it is. Like, people get anxious because they aren't sure they will, like, be able to do stuff later. So they try to overforce stuff, and then they lose. Like, right now, a lot of people would just, like, go, like, fight, I don't know. But I don't have ult, why would I fight? That will just become, like, Big Boss on Evelynn. Fuck off, enemy team. I'll just one-shot everyone. I don't give a fuck. Should have invaded more this game, but couldn't be bothered. And also, you don't need to like perma invade to like win. Just auto attack until he's in execute range and Q and stuff. The space, since these two are now pressured, and I can maybe go for him. Never mind, let's stay because this guy's trying to force. He'll probably go over the wall. Why would he go over the wall? Well, he doesn't know if I'm here or not anymore. My bot lane walks up, so. People who aren't very good at the game will do this. Bam, bam, bam. That guy's there, so let's react to that. Guess I'll probably kill him. Oh, this is a free kill. And he shut down as well. No, I should just take Herald. Nothing to do. Go invade, I have ult in 10. No. Wait and then invade. I have to be careful though because Akhtun can be here and I don't even know. So let's fuck up from this. Now let's kill him. Oh, I didn't get my E. Close. I shouldn't have ulted, that was a really useless ult, but whatever. Whatever. I think she wins that, but I'll go here anyway. I missed my Q, so she died. Not bad. Long you banning Rengar every game? Like, I mean, how long I've been doing that, or how long I'm gonna keep doing it? Because right now I'm just banning Jarvan every game. Rengar isn't picked enough. Meanwhile, Jarvan is perma picked and like wins into everything. But I've been banning Rengar like almost every game for like years. Fuck that champ, man. Can't be bothered. Don't like playing against it at all. I'll use my. Yeah, bro, I'm gonna stay. I don't have Rabadon's in base. No, no, no. Right. Shut up, Nami. Shut up, fucking NPC. The plan is I need to kill someone in mid and then just spawn Herald and take the mid tower. And when I open the map, like, enemy can't play because I'll take all of their camps. Wow, it's so nice when I can actually talk about the game and not just be like, oh yeah, bro, I killed that guy. Fuck off. Every single game from Iron to... From Iron to Silver was like that. It's like, yeah, I killed them. Wasn't even like playing the game, it was just like, yeah, I fight. Either finding a way to fight, or like... Finding the... I don't know. Finding the way to fight, so like getting enemy to fight me, or finding the way to fight as in like how to execute the fight itself. That was like main thing, those elos. No need to ult, just dies. I'll charm him so he can't like walk up and do anything. Rocket belt to avoid the Nivea shit. Just use rocket belt to avoid spells, to dodge and so on. Weird. I can turn this easily. That guy is behind us, but that's fine. I should have blocked that, I think. Yeah, I should have blocked that for sure. He would just die. This game is a good example of why you can choose whatever you want to do. Like, it doesn't really matter what you do, because, like, as long as you do it well, it's fine. Because this game, I didn't choose to invade. Like, this game, I chose to pretty much just play through lanes. And the thing is, while both are, like, options, and you can just, like, do either one, I suppose. And one is usually better than the other. In the Elo, it's like, whatever, no matter which one you do, as long as you do it well. The problem is just that when you climb, not being able to do both becomes, like, pretty bad. And most Evelyns can only do, like, the playing through lane thing. Their invading is, interesting. I'm not gonna die there because they didn't have cooldowns, I think. Okay, that's Hex Shrinker, interesting. It doesn't really matter, no matter what he buys, he won't survive. The guy also doesn't have the damage to kill me. Bring back old Dark Harvest? Kinda true. Kinda based. It's kinda fun. Oh, I didn't get my last Q. That would kill, by the way, that Q if it went on her instead of a minion. Because of Electric Proc, it would kill. I walked over a board here before, and now again. What are you doing, man? This quart is less fun than Eve, considering the Seedler is a farm for free. I mean, yeah. Quartus is more team reliant than Nevelyn. Also, if you like hit your shit Qs, and if you miss those Qs, it's just like, well, what do I do now? You go like invade the enemy, you don't like hit a single Q, and it's just like, well, blows, man. Sucks. Sucks, bro. I mean, it also kind of sucks if you don't hit like a single leveling Q, but I mean, not nearly as bad, let's be honest here. You can't compare like Evelyn Q and Karthus Q. Just hit them, it's not that hard. True. Just hit it, forehead. Just hit it, five head. Let's go. GG. GG.